Well, I think it's about time to show everyone and just remind everyone how my finger is just on the pulse, just red hot, every new figure. Yeah! By reviewing the last night deluxe squeaks. Because I want to. It's about the size of it, I want to. I dug him out again recently. You know when you're digging through figures and you're like, oh, I haven't looked at that for ages, and you just start messing with things. Took me a couple of days to find that bit, actually. I only had it, but I found it. And I really want to get this review done so I can, like, custom paint and fix this terrible paint job. But we'll get to that if you haven't seen it before. So you've got Squeaks, and the first thing we're going to do is we're going to pop off the little trailer a bit, which makes him Squeakus Prime. Why isn't that a thing? Do that. We'll get to that. Squeak! And he's a scooter! We haven't seen a scooter this lame. Ooh. Ninja Bills has a photo on Facebook. Nice. Sorry, Shinobi Biru. What was I? Yeah, scooters. We haven't seen a scooter transformer or transformery thing. I suppose I can say transformer because they own them now. Since the original scooter from GoBots. I really can't do that voice. Apologies. Although I believe it was Frank Welker. Frank Welker was Scooter. But, you know, he's a nice enough looking thing. You know, he's a little beaten up. If you've seen, like, I'm trying to think of something, like the Top Gear Vietnam special, things like that. You know, like the little, I think you gotta call them Asian now. But the yellow Asian, not the orange Asian. I'm not trying to be racist, I'm trying to be, like, specific. Those kind of areas. Then again, maybe India's got it as well. I don't know. I honestly don't know. Just ignore I said anything. But people tend to go around on these little scooters. Whereas, UK, probably American, things like that, they have the more rounded ones, whereas they like the more chunky ones. Maybe they're easier to fix. I don't know. But it's a nice little chunky thing, you know, twin headlights, wheel at the front, which I always get the feeling's wonky, but it isn't. Don't know, it's just me. Ah, it looks alright from the side, blah blah. And then it's got jet engines on the back. Like, what? Why? Why? Have they got a robot symbol and some kind of code that doesn't mean anything? Mean anything to you? Probably not. And it's got a little kickstand, so it can stand. And its wheel's actually off the ground. I'm not sure if they're supposed to lift the back wheel off the ground, but it's too far forward for that, but whatever. It's a nice enough little thing, and even this bit that flaps up to do the trailer, and it still only sits about there. And the dogs are fighting again because I'm doing a video. Well, starting to. So you've got a little patch where you could potentially have like a registration or something. You know what? It's quite cool. It's quite well designed. You know, this the seat, although it looks terrible. It just looks like, you know, for argument's sake, say this is metal. It just looks, or yeah, big chunky plastic. It just looks like someone's painted the top of it brown. It doesn't look like a cushion. It doesn't look padded. Doesn't look in any way like material. It just looks like brown painted plastic. Oi! Stop it! Every time! Ugh, kids. But I quite like this. You know, a little. Would that be the brake? I believe so. No, I quite like it. I do. Oi! Come on! I'm getting sick of it. And you got the trailer. Which we could take. Nope. Take that off. And it's a little box. It's got these translucent wheels. Which roll really well, don't get me wrong. Why are they translucent? I am. Sure, why not? You know, little ball joint hitch, which, you know, isn't bad. And this, it just looks like someone's got a paintbrush gone, done. Looks really bad. Like, honestly, really bad. And this side's, like, they did that bit, the paint side's run out, they've just done that bit and thrown it in the box. Like, there you are, send it. Looks really bad. And this looks like something should go there. I don't know what, though. And you get this, which is an accessory for the robot mode. And you can store it in that hole, that hole, that hole, that hole. And I don't want to stick it on the side because that looks ridiculous. So I just stick it on top and try and pretend it's not there. We'll deal with it later. I suppose if we do a size comparison, should we pretend he's hooked up for the size comparison? There you go. And we'll compare him with Kingdom Cheetah. So, considering... Yeah, he's a pretty reasonable deluxe when you think about it, compared to the standard ones. Or the modern standard, anyway. Okay, let's transform him. And for argument's sake, let's just flip up the kickstand. Okay, first thing we're going to do is fold down the front wheel and fold down the back wheel. The back wheel's got this little hook piece here, and you see that there? Goes into a little hole there. Front one's got this little nubbin sticking out there. It goes into that little hole underneath there. Folds up tabs in. Okay. And now they rotate a certain way. There are stops, like this big piece here sticking out. So it'll only turn a certain way, which would be... Get out of the way. That way. Apparently we can't have the kickstand down because it gets in the way. That way. You can't turn it the other way, because that's in the way, and there's one that side too. So you got to turn them that way. Come on, that way. Okay. Now we bring them up, rotate. You know what, we'll leave them down for now. We'll just leave them down for now, it's fine. Okay. So what I'm going to do is get these pieces here, and this hinge here, rotate them out. Rotate them out. Turn the handlebar section around. Now we need to get this this whole piece around here, this sort of upside down T shape, is a separate piece. So we need to pop this loose. And gosh, did you guess it was a separate piece due to the fact that the paint's completely off it? Pop that loose and then wriggle this out. If you can just about see in there, come on, where is it? Just about see in there, there's a double hinge. Get to there, turn this around, and then sort of drop it back into place. Okay. 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 So, there, what do you think? No, okay. We need to open up... Something opens up. What does it do? Open up this piece. All of this opens up. At which point we can flip all this out. And it's on a double hinge. There's a hinge here and there's a hinge at the back there. We want to get it all the way out. Ooh! Yeah, double hinge. Pin and pin. Two pins, double hinge. Close that back up. And now, using the little pin there, can you see that? Because this has been trying to move all the transformation. I need to fold this up, where these two little hooked pieces here on my finger, these two little bits here, it's going to... Those two tiny little holes in there, you see? That side and that side of the middle. Rotate up and go in there. Alright. Rotate this down so that this big tab goes into that slot there. There you go. I'm doing this too far away from the camera, I don't know why. Now we want to turn this, flip down this piece, which is the eyes. And the goggles and mouth. Excuse me. And then flip down the helmet. Now you might think, let me put that back how it was. You might think, oi! Come on! You might think something like, oh, why can't you just fold it all down? Well, you can't. This needs a specific clearance for the back tie, which I think is that one, to fit in. No, it might be that one, actually. Needs specific clearance, and without that gap between the eyes and the goggles, it won't fit. So that means all of this needs to move individually. Close that up. Now you can bring these up, rotate them to the side, bring it up, rotate to the side. You can leave the kickstand down as a like a third leg tripod support, or you can fold it up and it'll just sort of sit on his bum. but it's not too dissimilar, so do whatever you feel like. And that is Squeaks in his plain robot mode. He's missing something. Okay, yes, you're right. He's missing his little hands. And, I've been told you can transform him with those on. And I've tried messing with it, and it doesn't look good, so not really. So bring on this. Now we'll pop this off, and you can use this as an arm, using that peg, and you can plug in there, and I'll show you that in a bit, but we're not doing it yet. We need this. So we're going to fold out this side piece, and this side piece. We're going to fold up this whole top section, and we might as well fold that back. Now we can fold down the sides, and fold down the front. And that's his little play bassy thing. This is too high up, let's rotate down a bit. There you go. That might have fixed the whole review. Dogs, seriously, next time I hear you growling, you're in trouble. Stop it. Alright? Oi, youngin, leave him alone. He doesn't want to play, that's why he's growling. Leave him alone. Kids. Alright, okay. So in here, we've got this little toolbox, which you can open up, and there's a giant arm, which apparently in the film she stuck a big arm on him, and we'll get to that. But there are also these, which can be hidden in here. And these are little fake handlebar hands, which I'm not sure how it works, because the handlebars are sticking out the sides of his neck. But sure. Okay, well, we'll go for it anyway. So, they just plug into here. You can put them whichever way up you want. You pretend that's the hand and that's the thumb. Dealer's choice. And you can do that. And where's the chest plate wiggling around now? You know what? As pointless as he was in the film, and I can't actually remember him doing anything of any value at all. As pointless as he was in the film, this is kind of cute. This little follow thing. Beep, 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 beep. He's like R2-D2 of the Transformers world, but less useful. And I can get behind that, because R2-D2 had some serious plot armor. But wee little useless wheeling around thing with a jetpack. Because, yeah, that ends up on the back. And you go, wee! Absolutely ridiculous, and I do kind of love him for it. Don't get me wrong, I do. I suppose we should have a look at this thing while we're here. So we've got a toolbox, which you can open and close, and you can put stuff in, like this arm will just sit in there. And this, you can either close it up and plug it in top, or you can just plug it in there. Have it sit on the top, and it just looks like junk. And this is supposed to be like a repair bay. These you can bring up, they've got a hinge here, a hinge there, and a hinge there. And they can separate, but because of the way they are, they only really look good when they're together, that you can't bring them out to the side. So I'm not sure why you should separate them. So you might as well just leave them plugged together, to be honest with you. And this, see, I'm guessing these are lights or something, these six things. But then they're also 1, 2, 3, 4 molded in there as well. They're not in silver, but they seem to be roughly the same thing. So, lots of lights, lots of... I don't know, it's Transformers, make it whatever you want. So he's got a toolbox, he's got his stuff, he's got lights, diagnostics, whatever that is. You got this thing, which is actually like a robot arm. So it's got a swivel, hinge, 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 swivel, ball joint, and a little piece that folds out the end. Which, if I'm not mistaken, it's got another one of these things on the end of it. Light, torch, don't know. It has got a ball joint, so it's turn it around so it looks a bit more cohesive, like that. Reminds me of a Scutter from Red Dwarf. That's probably why I like this whole set, to be honest with you. It just kind of reminds me of a Scutter. And he can fit on this in both modes, but you can just sort of sit there and it can go, okay, let me just, you know. Oh, is your hat broken? I'm just going to take your hat off and fix what's inside your head and whatever. And I can go, oh, you need to fight. Okay, well, we'll just take your little hands off. I'll just take my foot there for now. Take your hands off, and we'll give you the other stuff. Okay. So we'll get the other stuff. Oh, that's me. Not the thing. Okay. Just so I don't lose those, I'm going to pop them back in the toolbox, which is handy. Close that back up. Okay. So you can get... We'll do this one first. And it's got a little peg in there, and it's clearly just a right arm. So you plug that in there, and now he's got a big robot arm. Sure, I mean, why not? And you can plug this into that, because it's got a 5mm grip. But it looks stupid, so don't. But here, if you look, it's actually got the shape, the little squared out shape there. And that can plug in there. It's just like Squeak's battle mode or something. He's got a decent arm that he could potentially punch things with. And absolutely ginormous shooty arm. So you can just be like... You go... Skid's just doing the drive-by. Oh, look, his tie's going out to the side, so he does actually kind of look like he's doing the whole skid turn. That's quite cool. Like I said, I don't think a kid would enjoy this at all. Like, just genuinely, I don't think a kid would enjoy this at all. But a giant nerd like me, just for something to mess around with, it's quite cool. So I kind of like him. I genuinely do. Do you want a size comparison for the robot mode? Another person who likes to fix things and build them. Earthrise Grapple. As far as the looks go, he's quite short. I might as well bring in Cheeto while I'm at it. As far as the looks go, he's quite short. That's fine. But this thing aside... Which, you know, would have been nice with a little bit of paint. I suppose I could do that if I wanted to. Not going to. All joking aside, he'd have been nicer with a little bit of paint. But he still looks cool. Just put that in there, close it up. I'm just going to close all this up. And transform him back, and let's just do it. Without pointing things out to you. Well, no, I'll do the head bit. I'll point the head bit out to you. As to why it has to be done that way. And you can do the wheels and stuff first, but it's a lot easier to do this before you do the wheels. So we're going to open... No, it's already open. What am I doing? Right. You need to open that up. Flip the goggles piece. Not the eyes. Flip the goggles piece back. Shove it into there. There's one way it likes to go. I think it's that way. You might have to fiddle with it for tolerances. But that's how it goes in. And it closes up. Fine. And then when you go to do these, which is that way, clip in there, and see the gap? Plus this has got a bit of mud guard on this side, but not on that side. So the helmet makes a bit of mud guard for that side. See? That's quite cool. Like, oh no, needs to do the whole chesty flippy thing first. Yeah, clip it. You close down. You close down. Yeah, if you leave the handles as the arms are sticking out like that. You can do that, it's up to you. If you've lost this and you don't want to lose the handlebars, then yeah, great, do it. But it doesn't look great. Okay, and just to prove the point, put that down, it can sit on there as well. Because, yeah, reasons. And so can Cheeto, haha! Cheeto can stand on there, okay. Right, flip this up, because this has got little tabs that go into slots on there, so you need to get this up. Close that to grow into the slot, there you go. Close that up, into there, okay. This goes over the top and closes, and lock up. And I'm just going to shove that on top, because why not? Ball joints. And flip that out. Lock the ball joint off. Come on. Really? There you go. And, what can I say? I kind of like it. I'm the underdog guy. Of course I like it. But yeah, I need to do something to tidy up this. You can make it look shabby without just smearing some brown on it and walking away. Especially considering it's the exact same brown as the seat. It's just really lazy. So I might have to do a little bit of custom paint on this. I'm not going to go silly with it, but just something. Just to take away from that. Maybe try and make that actually look like a seat. Stop these being so shiny. Because they really stand out. But whatever. Cheeto, ride the scooter. I did have Air Razor doing it before, but... Ah, well. So, yeah, there you go. Transformers The Last Night Deluxe Squeaks. He's a thing. Okay, you know what? I kind of wish I'd got Cogman from this line. Because it's only, like, last few months I realised he was a headmaster. I thought he was just, like, a terrible transforming robot thing. I didn't realise he was a headmaster. I'm like, ah, oh, now I kind of want him. Ooh, he's expensive. Ooh, no, let's not, no. No. Anyway, on that bombshell, I'm going to go, because how long is... Oh, over 20 minutes on this thing? All right, then. So, I should be okay, I should be ready, and I shall see all of you in the next one. Bye-zy-bye!